Nerdrotic.com.
I'm here to tell you I understand what the filmmaker was trying to say with the film Cuties. I'm also here to tell you that Netflix stock is tanking a day after Cancel Netflix was trending on Twitter all day because we understand you still filmed 11-year-old girls twerking. I don't give a damn what the context is. Does that context come across if you hit the mute button? Now, of course, the mainstream media predictably has come out and defended this film and made it a partisan issue, starting with Richard Brody, know that name, from The New Yorker. Cuties, the extraordinary Netflix debut that became the target of a right-wing campaign. That's right. It's a right-wing campaign to call out 11-year-old girls being filmed twerking in front of leering adults. Is that where you want to be, Richard Brody? Is that where you want to be, Scotty Mendelson from Forbes? Is that where you want to be, Tessa Thompson? Is that where you want to be, Hollywood and Netflix? You want to make this a partisan issue? Then so be it. Let's see what The New Yorker has to say. On Wednesday, Netflix releases Cuties, the remarkable first film from French filmmaker Mamanou Decore. Unfortunately, the platform's misleading advertising has given rise to a scurrilous campaign against the film itself. The promotional image showing young girls in bikini-like clothing dancing in provocative ways, all things that they film, all things you can see in clips if you dare. I wouldn't recommend seeing the film, but if you need to get that context, fine. I don't think it changes anything. As a matter of fact, I know it doesn't change anything. If you hit the mute button, does that message come across? Of course it doesn't. And of course, there's sick a-holes out there who will watch that stuff with the mute button on. That's precisely what we're talking about here. And there seems to be quite a few of them in a certain town in Southern California. And they would like to mention that this is an award-winning film. Well, one of the co-founders, once again, from Sundance, is on his way to jail for doing those very bad things that we are accusing this film of showing and attracting those type of people. I'm wondering why it won an award now. Matched with an inaccurate description has been taken to suggest that the film celebrates children's contextualized behavior. Of course, I'm using code speak. I have to on this platform to get this video out to as many people as possible, so please like, share, and subscribe. In fact, the subject of the film is exactly the opposite. It dramatizes the difficulties of growing up female and in a contextualized and commercialized media culture, one that you are happy to advertise right here and defend on this platform. Now, before I even go any further, I don't want any government agency to come in and mandate what kind of film you can make. I would like us, I know this is a freaking fantasy, I would like us collectively as adults to realize that there are just a couple of lines we shouldn't cross. That's all. That's it. Unfortunately, this is going to force that kind of mandate because you're pushing these boundaries, because you're trying to normalize something that shouldn't be normalized. There are other ways to get this message across. Maybe a documentary, maybe making the kids a bit older so you can have an 18-year-old play them, not filming 11-year-old girls twerking in front of leering adults, which happens in this film. I doubt that the scandal mongers, oh, we're scandal mongers. The New Yorker is calling YouTubers, and that's who they're talking about, scandal mongers, and people on Twitter as well. They're just tweeting. They're upset. That's their opinion. This is an issue that unites damn near everyone except for weirdos in the mainstream media and a bunch of weirdos in Hollywood. And I really want to say something much worse. So hopefully you know that my disdain for these people is without bounds. Richard Brody continues to dig a hole for himself. We're going to backtrack a little bit. Who include some well-known figures of the far right? So anyone calling this out is now of the far right. Have actually seen Cuties, but some elements of the film that weren't presented in the advertising would surely prove irritating to them. You mean the filming of 11-year-old girls twerking in front of leering adults? It's disgusting. A lot more than irritating. But it's very interesting to see that you don't have a problem with it. And here's why. It's the story of a girl's outrage at and the defiance of a patriarchal order. I'm not exactly sure how filming 11-year-old girls twerking in front of leering adults defeats the patriarchy. I think it will serve another purpose that you obviously don't have a problem with and maybe like. I don't know. It sure certainly sounds like you do. So we're going to get down to the very last paragraph, the last sentence. Its underlying subject is the connection of personal identity to public identity and the urgency of transforming the very notion of French identity, of changing the identity of who's considered the representative face of France. That idea is brought to the fore in an extraordinary brief symbolic ending. It's enough to give a right winger a conniption, a message that gets completely lost when you film 11-year-old girls doing inappropriate things in front of adults. And this is how Hollywood pushes the boundaries out. Now we see California are changing laws to make this kind of stuff easier. Go look into SB 145. It's something I can't bring up right here. It is pretty dark. And that's why the mainstream media built this narrative. So Netflix and the mainstream media wouldn't have to submit, because if they do, they would have to answer to their peers for bending the knee to a right-wing campaign, when in reality, this is nothing like that. This is a human campaign. That's why it was trending on Twitter all day, a platform that's very sympathetic to people like Scotty Mendelson and Richard Brody of The New Yorker. Controversy over Netflix's Cuties was outrageous, unfair, and incorrect. Disingenuous Scotty Mendelson. Now, those of us here in the Phantom Menace are very familiar with this guy. I just did a video on him. His takes are bad with Star Wars, and it turns out his takes are bad in real life as well. Now that I've seen the movie, the online outcry over Cuties, which finally debuted on Netflix this morning, was as absurd, overblown, and inaccurate as you'd probably expect. Talk about projection. The mainstream media and you, Scotty Mendelson, coming out and defending this film is predictable. That's all I can say. It's not disappointing. It's expected. That's exactly what we expect from someone like you, who wrote article after article defending The Last Jedi and accusing critics of it of being racist, bigots, homophobes. Yep, and that's what you're going to say here. Defending the sexualization of children. There, I said it. That's what you're doing, Scotty. It's not a good place to be. And I don't think, once again, you want to make this a partisan issue. This whole thing is disgusting, made more sick by the mainstream media defending it. The same mainstream media that wouldn't defend it if it was directed by a dude. And that's what this is all about. The fracking patriarchy. Bring it down, even if we have to film 11-year-old girls doing inappropriate things. If you like what you heard, please like, share, and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video.
Nerdrotic.com. Please subscribe.